Hello, and today we are with Mr. Maarten Voogd, who is the co-founder of Simonis Voogd Design. Good afternoon to you, Maarten.
Good afternoon, Steve.
I'm very excited to talk to you today because you are the designer of the SV14, which is the new boat for disabled people that you're selling around the world, but especially here in Thailand.
Yeah, well, we, Simonis Voogd Design, it's an international design company. And I'm running it together with my partner, business partner, Alex Simonis. And we've been working together for the last almost 30 years, so since 91. And the SV14 is a project we started 3 years ago. Yeah, basically following out of an announcement on Facebook from Pieter Jacobs, based here in Thailand. And he was asking one of his designer friends to design a boat for the parasailing community. And we took up the challenge. Yeah, like we've been doing our fair share in the boating world, and we thought, you know, it's time to give something back to the community. And this really looked for us like quite a nice challenge. And that was 3 years ago, and at that time we didn't really know what we were going for, but we do by now. So
I'm glad you used the word challenge, because there must have been a lot of challenges in creating this boat. What challenges, what are some of the biggest challenges you faced in creating the SV14?
Well, yeah, like to be honest, designing boats is a challenge in general, and this is a specific challenge. Well, let's put it this way. We are designers of keel boats, and we do a lot of different boats, but normally keel boats. And for us, this is the first time we design a sailing dinghy. But it's interesting because we designed it such a way, we approached it from our keelboat background and then specifically for the parasailing community. So it's basically a small version of boats we do in general.
You have four different types of SV14. How do those four different boats differ?
Well, in general, there are basically two versions. It's the version with the fixed seats and the version with the canting seats. You know, we spent a lot of time in developing a canting seat system in order to enable the people, the sailors, to sit always upright and creating also extra riding moment. Because our vision was that if people sit under a heeling angle, it's a very uncomfortable position. So, you know, we designed a system that they can always sit upright, and that's actuated by electric actuator. But that are the two basic versions. And then the four versions come out of the fact that the basic version is mainsail and jib. And then, you know, with the fixed seats, you can have the basic version, but then also the basic version plus the Jennaker, the bowsprit Jennaker arrangement. And that really makes it a proper racing boat. But we figured out that might be maybe a little bit too much for everybody, but that can always be fitted afterwards. So there are four versions, but basically, yeah, like can condense it to two versions.
Which of those two main versions has been the most popular in terms of sales?
Well, yeah, maybe I should give a bit of a background how the project started. It started as a home building kit, which was freely available, still is freely available on the internet to everybody in the whole world. And that was basically a copy of the mirror philosophy in the 1960s in England. And out of that boat, they built 77,000 boats. And that was our aim, you know, like we want to make this boat accessible to everybody. But the times now have changed from the 1960s to now. People don't really have the time and the patience to build a boat themselves. So we've been doing that for 2 years. And then 1.5 year ago, I approached Far East Boats, which we have a working relationship with for the last 10 years. And yeah, they had the same philosophy as us, yeah, like do something back to the community, because they've been doing a lot of work for the sailing world, and they've been earning their fair share of money as well. So also to produce this boat, but then in a proper production boat arrangement, and that's how the SV14 really got off the ground. And as we're sitting here in Thailand, in Siom Tien, yeah, it's the first time actually the production boats are together. We got a fleet of 9 boats here. And they're sailing here this week, and we'll see from there. But it's now really starting up, and there are a lot of talks with a lot of interested parties So yeah, we're very positive about the near future, that we really can spread the boat in the world. I mean, that's the main aim.
Exactly. Now, as you say, Thailand has already purchased quite a few of the boats here. Mm. Which other countries are you looking at, and how has Europe taken to this particular boat?
Well, you know, the interesting thing is that Simonis Voogd Design, we have two offices, one in Holland and one in Cape Town. And Alex Simonis, my partner, he is running the office in Cape Town. And so naturally there is a following of the SV14 class in Cape Town. And they purchased four boats from Far East, and they have two boats home built in Cape Town. So they have shortly, in the next couple of weeks, a fleet of six boats. I'm based in Holland, and in Holland there's also a very fanatic following of the SV14. And also two boats have been built in plywood in the Netherlands. And they looking into purchasing also four boats. So yeah, it starts small. We have to start somewhere. And yeah, we have the plywood versions have been built in New Zealand, in United States, in San Francisco, in Cape Town, in Thailand, in so all the places where the original wooden versions have started. We see now that the people are actually very interested in the production boat from Far East.
Technology, of course, is advancing all the time, and as we know with car manufacturers, plane manufacturers, there are always new versions coming out. How do you envisage the future of the SV14?
Well, what we try to achieve and what we will achieve is that it's going to be a strict one design class. So, well, you know, like the boats we have here at the moment in Thailand, they still a bit of the guinea pig version of the one design class, but we'll make sure that all the boats, yeah, the weight and the sail area, everything is going to be strict one design. And it will be a developing class, but in general we pretty much fixed in the most important areas, yeah, like keel weight, keel area, rudder blades, everything, that's all fixed, hull shape, so there's nothing going to change there anymore. And so it's going to be a strict one design class. And well, yeah, like we don't want to stop the evolution of the class. You always need to keep an eye open for new technologies, etc. But we can't change it too much, because yeah, that would jeopardize the one design status.
In terms of materials and technology, 3D printing is becoming more and more popular around the world. How do you envisage the technology changing things from that perspective?
Yeah, and that's the interesting part of Far East. They're a very innovative company. That's why the slogan of the company is unlimited innovation. And yeah, like I think they are pretty unique in that respect. What they really in very good in is optimizing the production methods and efficiency of producing the boats. And what's important with that is that we can generate very constant quality. But more importantly, if we can cut down on the amount of hours to produce the boats, we can keep the boat at a very low price level. And the price level of this boat, which is about one third of competitors in the market, that we think will enable us to actually spread the fleet worldwide, because it's a very affordable boat. It's a very modern boat. It's really latest thinking of yacht design. Yeah, it's got a carbon fiber keel fin, rudder blades, etc. The hull shape is very much in line with the latest thinking in yacht design. And if we can keep the price low down, then naturally it's very accessible to a broad range of people.
You must feel very proud as a company and as a person to be able to develop and design something that just a few years ago disabled people would never have dreamt it possible to go sailing, and yet you and your company has managed to make this possible for them. You've met some of the people that you've changed their lives in it being able to do this. What are some of the things that have touched you the most, the people that you've met and talked to? What are some of the things that have touched you the most in terms of what you've accomplished with this?
Well, what I think the biggest accomplishment of this boat actually is, in my opinion, is that the disability of the people disappears straight away when they go sailing in the boat. And yeah, the boat gives a lot of freedom, but the beauty of this boat actually, and I really get the shivers of that, yeah, if I think about it, because the beauty of this boat is that the boat is not only nice for the specific group of people we designed the boat for, but also for the other people, like the able bodies. And that the combination of able body sailing with disabled people, I mean, it it's so nice that there are no restrictions anymore, and we can really enjoy time on the water together, and that's the biggest thing, and that's one of the things which is going to be more and more important in the sailing world, but I think in general in the world, that you know, the disability, the group of disabled people, it was always a bit of a separate group, and with this boat we become one family, and that I think is the biggest achievement of this boat, besides all the effort being put in by especially Far East as well, to enable to build the boat.
At the moment, your the SV14 is for one disabled person plus another sailor as well, I believe. Do you have any options in the future for having possibly a couple of disabled people on one boat? Is that feasible?
Absolutely. Like they're sailing here this week with two disabled persons in the boat. So no, anybody can sail the boat. Like, but think about it as well. Yeah, it's not only about disabled people, but you can think about your grandfather with your son. Yeah, like these type of combinations, everything is possible, and that's what I'm saying. It levels the whole playing field of people sailing the boat, and you can all compete against each other on an even level, and well, that's the beauty of it.
I think that's a perfect place to start. Maarten, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today, and also congratulations to you and to Simonis Voogd for achieving such a great thing with yachting for disabled people. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stephen.